A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6 September, on the front page you have Chidambaram sent to Tihar jail till September 19 in INX media case. So former finance minister and his son got anticipatory bail in Aircel Max's money laundering case, but in INX media case he has been sent to Tihar jail. Then this is Supreme Court allows Iltija Mufti to meet her mother Mehbooba. So this is the development in Jammu and Kashmir. So it has been said that local authorities should be asked for permission to go around in Jammu and Kashmir. So Supreme Court has allowed her to meet her detained mother. Then below you have Romila Thapar declines to send CV to JNU. So this is a central government which had asked Jawaharlal Nehru University's professor emerita. So she has been given this position for life. So the government is seeking reviewing of this position of hers. So administration of Jawaharlal Nehru says that it is reviewing. It is a government controlled university. So this review as such has been questioned. She has been asked to send her CVs, but she has refused to send her CVs. She said, I have sent a letter explaining what Professor Emerita status means, because it is a status which has been given on work which has already been done. It's a position of honor and it is not based on future expectations. So this letter has been sent. It is also, it is also evident that she's an ancient history writer. She's a renowned historian, and she has not conformed to the rightist approach to history. So that is also a reason for targeting is speculated. Then this is Institute of Eminence tag for 5. So, Human Resource Development Ministry has awarded status of Institute of Eminence to IIT Madras, IIT Kharagpur, Delhi University, Banaras Hindu University and University of Hyderabad. Then below you have India lends $1 billion for Russia's Far East. So, India has announced an unprecedented $1 billion line of credit for the development of Russia's Far East. So the two countries are working together now. It said it's a unique case of India providing such special credit line to another country. On page 7 you have state gets first electric bus Shivai for intercity services. So this is Maharashtra State Road Transport Corporation, which has inducted its first electric bus. It has been called Shivai. So it was inaugurated. The bus can run for 300 km on one charge and takes between 1 and 5 hours for a full charge. Then on page 9 you have government launches campaign to promote Eat Right movement. So India's health ministry, central government health ministry, has announced Poshan Maha 2019 with a year-long social and mass media campaign on Eat Right India movement. So it said this is crucial measure to trigger social and behavioral changes. Then this is this monsoon, Mumbai has got more rain than annual average. So here you can see this is the rainfall in Mumbai, which is given here, how short bursts have resulted in flooding in various parts of the city. And here you have light combat aircraft pricing issue resolved, says Ministry of Defense. So major changes in defense procurement procedure have been outlined so that the light combat aircraft, so there are 83 light combat aircrafts which have been manufactured by HAL. So their purchase has been finalized. On the editorial page you have interesting but risky. So this is regarding RBI's diktat to banks that their lending should be linked to an external benchmark. Lending to retail loans and MSMEs. So, so this is called as a risky venture. It says that this could spur borrowing but may pressure lenders' margin. The bank's margins may be affected. Then this is a weak chase. So this is regarding hepatitis B virus. It says controlling the hepatitis B virus calls for universal vaccination of newborns. So that is the key here. So that is detailed out, hepatitis B. The dose has to be given in the first 24 hours. This can help prevent vertical transmission from mother to child. The lead article Teaching in the Time of Consumerism. So this talks about how changes in social ethos and state policy have pushed once venerated Indian teachers to the margins of public life. So it's not a sought after profession. Then this is putting the medal to the metal. So this is how government should consider dropping GST rates for BS4 vehicles to revive the automobile industry. So this is one initiative which is being pushed for and argued for in this article. Then on Fridays on the op-ed page, you have parlay coverage in which a question is put forth and views, counter views are given. So this is regarding public sector banks mergers which took place. 10 banks have been merged into 4. So the question is, will PSB mergers alter the banking scenario? So the view counter view is given, because consolidation will cause disruption in the short run, but how could it lead to better, you know, banking system in the country in future has to be seen. On page 12, you have World Health Organization Southeast Asia region plans to banish measles, rubella by 2023. So, a resolution has been adopted at the World Health Organization Regional Committee for the same. On page 13, you have Russia for joint submarine development. So, Russia has offered joint design and development of conventional submarines through intergovernmental agreement as such with India. So technology transfer will happen in this conventional vessels, which will be built to the Navy's requirements. On international page, you have continuation of the same news. This is regarding Brexit issue. So it's a continued news. We don't need to cover it every day. This is regarding US-China trade talks. So they are going to resume. So once the talks resume and further developments happen, we'll talk about it. Then this is regarding cyber attacks in Afghanistan, which continue while US and Taliban are having dialogue. This is regarding Hong Kong. So again, calls for dialogue have been made. So this is a continuing issue. And this is a local US issue, so we can skip it. On business page, you have government looking at export SOPs, GST incentives for auto sector. So this is the Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari, who has promised to take up industry's plea for cut in GST with the Finance Minister. So this is also a continuing issue actually. GST has to be reduced. Demands have been made often. Again, the demand, it is said, will be taken forward from the Transport Ministry to Finance Ministry. Then there is no other relevant news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.